Hello, so we are at the warehouse, and this will be a very weird map. I think we'll have traps. Okay, you guys have to go. Yeah, there are a lot of zombies, and most of them you have to kill, otherwise they'll just, you know, swarm you at a very, very bad time. So I've upgraded the damage for the Molotov cocktails and explosives, so we should be able to clear them out pretty easy. But I think they need to increase the range of the Molotov and the explosives. You want a hug? Okay, I'll hug you. Ah, go down. There's nothing nicer than a liver shot to kill a zombie. By the way, there are probably 40 zombies over there at the entrance. Also, I've upgraded a lot of stuff. I've been playing, but I've not been recording, so I'm a little over level, or not really over level, but just leveled up. I also hate that they don't swap to your weapon after you use a grenade or Molotov cocktail. Oh, they really need to fix some of the shooting mechanics because I'm missing so many bullets. Why is this guy slowly coming to me? Okay, what is another good melee weapon? I guess the baton is decent enough. Also, if you want to make use of your melee weapons, you have to upgrade your stun chance as well. Now, I hope these zombies will have ammo, otherwise we'll have problems. Yeah, this is one of those story missions where you have a lot of zombies to kill. Let's save some of that ammo for the big guy that is surely in the entranceway. This is almost like exactly like the military base, except it's a little harder because you'll have to fight either a very big horde or a very big guy. Or both at the same time if you don't play your cards right. An interesting thing is that you can make the can bombs very easy, even on the go, you don't need a workbench. Equipped, medkit. Yeah, I'll hope I'll find a lot of ammo because this is not enough for what we need. Now, do I need the sports rifle? Probably. And also, zombies will start to gather on that other side. Oh, great timing, great timing. The warehouse is on fire. Well, that's a big problem. We're looking for supplies here, but I'm not sure we'll find surprises. I'm not sure we'll find supplies, we'll just find surprises. That should be enough to kill most of them. Beautiful, what can I say? Oh, that's why I couldn't see him. He's one of the stealthy guys. How did he get me? I have no idea. Well, I have an idea. It's actually pretty hard to get out of that stance. So I press the button to dodge roll away, but yeah. It's delayed. It's a little delayed. And besides, I was over here in the... I don't know. That's just stupid because there's no way you can shoot that guy crouching with the sandbags. You have to stand exactly over here and that means you'll get hit. Ah. Annoying. Very annoying. What can I say? This is what At least he's not one of those big guys. Check out the we know sign. So people must know what Turk is doing and they're actually burning them down. Sadly, I have to pick up every bit of item because otherwise I have no idea what loot is here. So I think they should just make a tab. So press tab to see all loot around you from dead zombies. So you don't have to pick up everything, just so you can see every piece of loot. Wait, Antizine is in here? Where? By the way, sometimes it's better to have a pistol without a suppressor because this way zombies near you will come near you. Oh, over here, they are so hard to see. Well, I guess I'll not be finishing the game this run. Also, for some mysterious reason, you know, food is becoming a lot more scarce in the game. So yeah, I probably have to invest some points into the food. Good lucky chance as well. What? What are you doing over there? How did you get on top of there, you silly zombie? That's not a place where a zombie should spawn. Well, I guess we're waiting for the first big patch because the developer said we need a patch. Oh yeah, I think you get an automatic gas can if you get this mission. By the way, I've done this mission before, it was bugged. And you know what happened? I couldn't finish the mission. Well, let's just say it was a bug. But when I tried to leave the area, I got teleported back here. How are you supposed to fight a big guy in such a... Okay, that's a problem. I have an M16, but I have no ammo for it. Yeah, this will be tricky. This is one of the things I don't like about the game. How are you supposed to do this? I don't think it will work. But we do have a big sword. We can try to hit him with a big sword. We're going to hit him with a baseball bat. That's going to leave a mark. For the stupid grenade already. I don't know what exploded. I think I... Yeah, this is why you upgrade the damage of the grenades. Oh, what? Well, that's beyond unfair. Come on, two elites in the basement. I think the game has a internal clock or something, or a hidden mechanic that actually calculates the strength of the zombies, because last time I went here, I only got an elite in the doorway, and I got an elite in the doorway, and it was only a leaper, but no. They had to put a big guy and a leaper in here. That scared me. Also, there is not much loot in here, so sadly, you will have to make do with what you have. Yeah, forgot to reload it. I don't know why they put the gates over here. There's nothing behind them. Oh, there's something really, really wrong with the spawn system. No, normally I would take the ammo, but no, I'm too greedy to take the ammo. There shouldn't be a supply crate in here. Okay, that activates the generator and that activates the fire suppression. Now let's see if the game doesn't bug out this time. So last time I picked up the explosives, he said I picked up only 2 out of 4 explosives, but I have enough to put over there, so I don't know. I basically had 4 explosives, but the game told me I only had 2 out of 4. And yeah, when I tried to leave the place, they didn't let me. They just brought me back here. Okay, I guess this is all we needed. That scared me, I thought that lamp was a zombie. Okay, so let's see. Yeah, everything is burnt out. That's disappointing. So what else is there? Canisters full of flesh. I think that's what they call it. Canisters flesh. How many? A lot of them. Yeah, I think they're using those to generate the radio signals. Yeah. Well, I'll give the game credit because it's trying to have a story. But I just think these story missions are way too much of a hassle. Look at this. Okay, I might be stuck here, so I have to be careful. Blocked by a chair. Okay, let's wait until our stamina fully restores and then we can attempt to jump over the huge chair that is preventing our escape. Somehow I don't think people really tested this game when it was released. I don't know, it's just a hunch. So those are burning debris, or actually not burning, smoldering debris. So we have 2 explosive wall charges. Oh, actually triggered. Okay, this time it worked. Also, we have a lot of water over here, just in case you're thirsty. And I think this is the other crate with the explosive. Yeah. 9 out of 9, yeah. This place should have a lot more loot, especially anti-zim, because it seems like they're a huge waste of time. Let's actually put the last one over there. We'll put the last one on the wall. Get in the car and leave. That's the best objective ever. Do I want to do anything else? Maybe I want to cook something on the barrel. Yeah, let's try cooking something on the barrel. That zombie is really trying to get to me. By the way, look at my weight. The funniest thing was me trying to melee that huge guy, that huge zombie with a baseball bat. Yeah. I don't think he even flinched. So this is always a stun almost, right? Right, oh hey. I guess you kind of double hit with the melee weapons if you just swing them while the zombie is going down. Also have a big fuel can on our back. And that's it. Do we get to see the explosion, or are we too cool to see the explosion? At least they gave us a sound trigger or something to see it. Yeah, the smoke. Okay. Well, I guess I can do the military checkpoint as well since we have a little bit of time. Who knows, maybe I'll even die over here. Yeah, in this game you never know. Sometimes I was stopped because I didn't have gas in the middle of nowhere, and once I get out of my car, 2 groups of running zombies attack me. So that's 10 zombies, 5 in one direction, 5 in the other. That's an automatic end game. Oh, I like this map. The bridge one with the water. Look at this. Also, I've increased the damage of my pistols, so that's why I'm killing the zombies so fast with only one shot. Also, this makes ammo a little tricky. Now I'm hunting for batteries. Usually the batteries are in the ruined car, so that's why I search all of them, see? I don't know why they gather on those things. I actually saw the leaper over there. I saw him and I was trying to lure him, and that actually worked. Maybe a little too good. And what can I say? I was expecting a big guy. Yeah, I also need to. Well, he got me. There's no way you can avoid both of them at the same time. Yeah, they are very hard to kill if they are together. Yeah, the game really has some internal clock or trigger that will make the zombie spawn a lot. Oh, what is that? That zombie is taking a bath. That will make the zombie a lot more dangerous. Especially when you have two of them like this. Don't get too close to the thing. That was not fair. I don't think we can heal this with the antidotes. No. Oh man, the game is so weird sometimes. I mean, by just simply, I mean, you kill so many strong zombies, a lot of zombies, you kill hundreds of zombies, and then you walk by a little crazy thing like that and you get two levels of infection. And the game says, it's fair. Of course it's fair, why would I have I don't know. And this is what I mean, most of your runs will just end because you made a simple mistake, and it's not even related to the zombie or anything else, it's just related to the fact that you were too close to something. You press something at the wrong time, I don't know. Yeah, we have to use a lot of explosives, otherwise we'll never get through the zombie hordes. Splatter. And it's also pretty obvious that you cannot use stealth at a certain point. In order to unlock this thing over here to get the antizen, you have to kill both of the elites anyway. That was a quick kill. I almost forgot you could do that, I haven't done it in a long time. Yeah, let's get the... It really has antizen in my experience. Also, this crate is sometimes empty. By sometimes, I mean a lot. No point into opening that one. Oh, Oh, we had another one over here, a spare one. It looks like this is why I hoard the batteries. I just love the thing's metal sound. Now, is it worth going into this area? Probably not. Let's see if it works over the fences. Yeah, it works. So, what else do I have for a big boom? No, well, I have grenades. That should be more than enough. Also, I can use the other pistol now. Another thing I learned the hard way is if you have good ammo or good weapons, just use them, because you will never get to the end game in a, I don't know, timely matter. So just use them to have a better gameplay. A better time of the game. But I still don't use the flare gun. I guess I could use it now for gameplay purpose. What's in here? The fuel canister, right? Yeah, yeah, zombie, I know you're not here, you're in the valley probably. So this thing can blow up, or almost blow up. Or maybe it just makes a lot of noise. Probably it makes a lot of noise. Let's use the improvised suppressor, as they call it. Oh, this is a destroyed bridge. That's interesting. Mostly killing them for experience. And I thought that that healing will heal all of your hearts, but no, it doesn't do it like that. So what's the point of taking this perk? Just to get healing, which is one of the easiest items to find in the game? That's not a happy sound. That's so scary, the zombies are underneath you and you don't see them, but you hear them like they are next to you. Well, I guess if I really want to reach the radio tower, we'll have to go over here, but that's where I guess everything is free scrolls, yeah. Let's see how it looks like. I hope it's a day map. These night maps are so annoying. Most of the times you die because you are going to get hit by some zombie that you cannot shoot because the hitboxes are not right. Either by that little mistake I did over there because the range of that explosion is not very well defined, and if it explodes you actually have no time. It's almost like hit detection, it's instant. And there's no cure for that poison, which is annoying. Okay, let's do the inventory. I guess I have enough to kill most zombies. Oh, so much supplies. Okay, thank you. See you next time.